I am International Master Attila Szuburzo from Hungary. In this lecture, we will study the sketch opening from White's perspective. This lecture is about the basics, the basic ideas of the sketch. The starting position of the sketch opening will be after White starts with e2, e4, black plays e7, e5, and after the e5 move, white plays knight f3 to attack the e5 pawn. Black defends with knight c6. And this is the starting position of many openings. After bishop b5, we arrive to the Ruy Lopez opening. If white plays bishop c4, then we are in the Italian opening. And those moves gives the possibility for the players to have a close center, but here white can immediately open the center and open the diagonal for the c1 bishop and open space for the queen by d2 d4. Sometimes the players thought maybe this is a little early to open the position, open the center. This may give not big advantage, but recently, many strong players started to play this because this also gives a very nice and free piece play for white, and also this gives many times sharp positions, which very good if you are good in calculation lines and if you like nice funny positions and good attacks. After d4, black should capture on d4. Otherwise, if he defends the e5 pawn by d6, then white can get easy advantage by bishop b5, or can simply advance the pawn to d5 and winning space, or even can capture on e5, and after black captured black, white can capture on d8, and black cannot castles anymore because he cannot capture with the knight because he needs to defend on e5, and after bishop c4, white has, I think, little advantage, but very solid position to give good future. So in the position after d2, d4, black should capture on d4. And after this move, white can play bishop c4 or c3 to play in gambit style, but in this lecture we will study the sketch opening, where white capture back on d4 with the knight. This is the starting position. Let's have a little look about this position. White has a pawn in the center on e4, controlling d5 and f5 squares. Compared to that pawn, black has a pawn on d7. So if you look the pawns, then white has some advantage, because he has more space behind the pawn. If we look the pieces, both white developed one knight and also black developed one knight, and black to move so he can start the developing faster the pieces. That's an advantage for black. So black has a little advantage in time, and white has advantage in space and control in the center. In this position, two very logical developing moves are the two main lines. Black can develop the kingside bishop with bishop c5, and by this move also attacking the d4 knight, trying to win more time and be ready for castling as soon as possible when develop the g8 knight. The other possible move is knight f6 here, developing the knight and attacking the e4 pawn. So black would like to try to attack the white center and have development advantage. White would like to consolidate the about the development, so it would like to have same developed pieces like black, but we'd have some space advantage, because of the e4 pawn, and then he would like to have a little but solid advantage because of the space, because of much space. So the two main moves, bishop c5 and knight f6. Here also possible some other moves like queen h4. This is a very sometimes dangerous variation, also for dangerous for white, dangerous for black. Most of the time after this move, white sacrifices a pawn, but black will have problems with his king. The e4 pawn is under attack, and there is no good defense of the pawn. White can defend with the knight c3, but after bishop b4, there is no good defense on the pawn. But how we will look, white can sacrifice that pawn because black lose too much time with the queen. And for the pawn, white will have development advantage and good attack against the king after knight b5 move. Because of the queen movement, the c7 pawn would be vulnerable. So queen h4 also a possible idea here. And the queen also sometimes develops an f6, also with the idea, with a direct attack on the d4 knight, trying to win some more time and make some complications. Or in this position also possible to capture on d4, but I think this is quite bad for black, because white can simply capture back and have a very nice queen in the center, which attacks on the king side and on the d5. And if black plays queen f6, this is most of the time the idea of capturing on d4, to then trying to exchange also the queens, but after e5, white will have a very nice position because of the space advantage, and also he can later, after queen b6, he can develop the bishop to e3 and knight c3, castling long, and a very well developed pieces. So the knight takes d4 is not so good. Here two more important moves, I think, which we should look a little bit. The bishop b4, which was played recently also in the game of Kasparov. It was now not so young game, I think it was around 10 years ago, or at least 8 years ago. Peter Leko played it against Kasparov. The idea of this move is to provocate the c3 move, because otherwise, if the knight c3, then maybe black can play simply knight f6, going to the 4-knight defense, which would be a okay position for black, but white would play c3 to winning time, forcing the bishop back. But after bishop e7, the b1 knight could not develop on c3 easily, so this is the advantage for black. But black lost time, and also the c3 bishop has to cover the center, so this is also, I think, good for white, gives some small advantage. And one more is the d6 move. So black captured on d4 because the e5 pawn was attacked, and now he decides to open in the diagonal for the other bishop and playing, developing very solidly. But this gives a solid position for black, but also passive position. I think it's also possible just to develop knight c3, knight f6, and then to play simply bishop e2. Castling, and because of the e4 pawn compared to the d6 pawn, white has some nice advantage because of the control d5 and f5 squares and more space. Also, in this type of position, white can play bishop b5 if he wants to play very aggressive, immediately developing the bishop, preparing castling, and later can capture the knight with the bishop, creating double pawns, and then the d4 knight will be even more stronger because it will be very hard for black to exchange it. The other possible moves, I think, g6 or knight g7. Also possible, against this I would suggest to play simply knight c3, and if bishop g7 then bishop e3, and later to play for queen d2 and castling long, then playing for bishop h6 and then h4 h5 attacks. I think similar ideas could be played against knight e7, knight c3, and then going for a kingside attack after bishop e3, queen d2. Now we know all the main moves, and I would like to go a little deeper about the two main moves. So after d4, e takes d4, knight takes d4, and one of the moves which I would like to look a little deeper is bishop c5. After bishop c5, I would suggest you to capture on c6. It's also possible to play bishop e3. This is a little bit more defensive move. Defend the d4 knight and then later want to play for an attack. But I would like to suggest you to capture on c6, immediately solve the problem of the knight. Here the main move is queen f6, tricky move. Black did not capture back the knight, but created a mate threat. If black captures back, if you capture back with the pawn, then the d pawn, then you can exchange queens and then have a very good endgame because of the 4 pawns on the king side against the 3 pawns, and on the queen side, black has a double pawns, and with the 3 pawns we can block his 4 pawns, and then it is a like pawn advantage on the king side for white. So in this position black would capture back with the pawn, but then I think after bishop d3 we would like to castle, to have a very nice position for white, which is typical to play then king h1 and then f4, e5, f5, he wants fast king side attack. Also, many times we want that type of plan in the queen f6 lines also. So after queen f6, there is a mate threat on f2, and I would like to suggest to play queen d2 to defend that pawn. Also, would be possible to defend it from e2, but then the bishop would be blocked. So one of the bishop would be blocked anyway, but I would like to say this move to be able to play bishop d3 later maybe, and then castling and following our plan to advancing the f-pawn after king h1. Here black can capture with the queen, with the d-pawn, with the b-pawn. In this starting lecture we just looked the main move. Black captures with the d-pawn with the idea to winning time by opening the diagonal of the bishop as soon as possible, and then also sometimes rook d8 may come. I think after this move we can play bishop d3, and if black develops like bishop e6, then we can castle, and then following the original plan king h1 and then f4. Later, to develop the c1 bishop, we may play queen e2, and then we can develop the bishop to e3 or d2. Also, sometimes we just go for a better endgame by playing queen g5 or queen f4 to exchanging the queens, and then trying to play a better endgame with 4 pawns against the 3 pawns on the king side. Let us go back a little bit. So in the bishop c5 line, we capture on c6, and then our plan is bishop d3, castling fast, and then king h1, and then f4. And if need, then with the queen, we defend the f2 pawn. Also, we may go to a better endgame sometimes if black captures with the d-pawn back on c6. Then we want to try to play for the kingside pawn majority. The other main move, which I would like to cover a little bit in this lecture, is the knight f6 move. By knight f6, black capture, was threatening to capture the e4 pawn, so white should solve this problem immediately. If you play knight c3, then we go to another opening by bishop b4, this is the 4-knight defense. But in this position we can play a special scratch idea, the idea from the scratch opening. We can again capture on c6, and with the idea to play e4, e5. Okay, immediately e5 is not possible because the knight covers. So first you capture the knight, then black should capture with the b pawn. Another way, if with the d pawn, then we would again exchange the queens and have a better endgame. So black captures back with the b pawn, and then we play e5, because now black should solve the problem of the knight. I think there is only one good move for the knight, is d5, because if he moves to e4, then he may have problems, maybe after bishop d3 or queen f3, the knight position could be very vulnerable and should lose more time. Which are played from this position is knight d5, if we move with the knight, and then with white we attack the knight with c4, winning space, and then again to play bishop d3, and then try to castle as fast as possible, and developing the knight to c3, the bishop to e3 or f4, depending what will black do. If black will exchange the pawns, then we would play to f4. If we don't capture, then e3, and then try to advance the f pawn. And having a better pawn structure, most of the endgames are better for white, so we are always ready to exchange queens. If we look other ways, the position is enough solid and we can go for endgame with a better pawn structure. But the main move after e5 is a counter-attacking move, is queen e7. By this move, black pins our e5 pawn, and it looks like we have a big problem. There is only one good move to solve this problem. We need to play queen e2, unpin the pawn. Little funny, not? The two queens in the early phase of the game already moved, and they both blocking the bishops. But later the plan would be for both bishops to develop to on another way. Black would like to play g6, bishop g7, and white would like to play g3, bishop g2. Now the knight is attacked and need to move. Now to move knight d5. Then we attack again with c4. If the knight goes back to b6, then I think we can play knight c3 and g3, bishop g2. Sometimes to play b3 if the c4 pawn would be attacked, maybe with the bishop or with the queen. And this gives, I think, a nice position for white. Those are the basic ideas here: to play g3, bishop g2, b2, bishop b3, bishop b2, and with that nice bishops attacking the center, and again looking for the double c pawns can be a possibility later in the endgame for white to have a better position. Instead of knight b6, black can play bishop a6, pinning again with a pin to solve the problem of the knight, first with queen e7, now with bishop a6, trying to solve. And after this move, I think the best to play b3 to defend that pawn, and again our idea is to develop the bishops on fianchetto mode, to bishop b2 and g3, bishop g2. The knight may go to c3 or d2, and then castling short gives, I think, a solid good position for white. We cover these systems, also the bishop c5 and also the knight f6 systems in other lectures in more details. Let us go back to the beginning. So in both systems we would like to capture on c6 and then have fast development and having some space advantage, and later to use the space advantage to have attack against the opponent king. I wish you great games in the Scratch opening, and I invite you to view our other lectures on this with other variations in more details. Thank you very much for your attention, and see you soon.